First of all, you have noticed from this first warm-up session that you are not here in a sort of standard symposium. Hein? This is something totally different that we are organizing. Donc c'est aussi l'idée de, pour les pays de l'Union européenne, de dialoguer aussi avec les autres pays du monde. Cette année, c'est évidemment celui de la crise, mais évidemment, comment le dialogue social peut-il aider à sortir de sa crise?
So this is the Labour Administration, Labour Policy Corner.
How to have a global policy to overcome the crisis?
Yes. So we have the Labour Administration like facilitator between the government
yeah.
and
the
It's not that there were decent work deficits only now, since the financial and economic crisis came about, but there was actually a decent work crisis before in many countries around the world with respect to unemployment, working poverty, informal employment, and this is not to mention the fuel and food crises in many developing countries, which with the rise of oil prices and the consequent rise in food and fuel prices was a serious impediment on workers in many countries around the world. It emphasizes social dialogue as one of the key pillars for dealing with the crisis.
Because it is rare that these short working time schemes are negotiated in the UK. And second, because here the workers and the management have agreed to sacrifice pay, which can save jobs, which is again something new, and it might become more widespread in the future. And then industrial action, then I don't think I'm surprising you here by saying that there hasn't been an enormous lot of industrial action in the member states. People are very much concerned. They are afraid about what the future would bring to them. So there were very low industrial action volumes in all Europe, in all member states. Of course, we had some protests because people were not happy with the measures taken. Who is paying for the crisis, really? That was their concern. We've noticed that the industrial relations institutions have been playing a major role in containing the negative consequences of the crisis. We had coordinated bargaining, employee representation in the workplace, when we had regular consultation. It really worked well.
So the challenge now would be to answer to this first question.
Building a pyramid there? Or building a pyramid there?
Yeah.
Yes.
In our case in Turkey, we have several organizations which are in global world producing their products for multinational companies.
Representing the employers, we should also add for the employers not only the lack of income, but the lack of credits and financial support.
And our discussion is summarized according to, you can see here, answering to the first question, we have three issues to be stressed. Unemployment, of course, decline of income, and also insecurity and some violation on fundamental rights such as access to education, access to healthcare of high quality, and also violation on right to make a collective bargaining.
Les pertes d'emploi affectent évidemment en priorité les groupes vulnérables sur le marché du travail, dans lequel on retrouve les jeunes, ou en tout cas ceux qui sont au début de leur vie professionnelle, les travailleurs immigrants, les travailleuses immigrées et peut-être d'autres groupes, alors là la proportion est difficile à dire, selon les pays, les travailleuses âgées et éventuellement les femmes. Sur les femmes, peut-être que les opinions ont été divisées, parce que dans certains pays, cela semble net, dans d'autres pays, ce n'est pas net. On pense que c'est les hommes sont plus affectés que les femmes. Et peut-être parce que beaucoup de femmes travaillent à temps partiel et que le travail à temps partiel est moins affecté par la crise que les travailleurs à temps plein.
But we still, we have some indicators that things are going better. They are not going worse like other groups. So, when we came to vote, we have nobody think that it will be worse.
Même si l'impact de cette crise et aussi sa durée diffèrent d'une région à une autre et d'un pays à l'autre.
Les partenaires sociaux et le gouvernement ont essayé de travailler ensemble pour trouver les réponses nécessaires à la crise.
L'Union européenne s'était ralliée à une stratégie dite de flexicurity. De flexicurity. Les organisations patronales et syndicales s'y étaient ralliées au niveau européen. Et donc il y a eu un débat qui s'est immédiatement ouvert. Est-ce que la stratégie de flexicurity était adaptée pour faire face à la crise? Pour interpréter ce qui s'est passé, je propose dans mon rapport deux démarches. D'abord, mettre l'accent sur l'hétérogénéité, la diversité des situations nationales. La conclusion découle directement de l'analyse précédente. Je crois que nous avons deux phases bien contrastées. Une phase qui va de l'été 2008 au printemps 2009, où l'urgence est de faire face à la crise, de mettre en place des plans de relance, et ceci crée les bases d'un consensus tripartite.
This crisis cannot be managed without sacrifices. But this year it turned out that most countries of our region, I mean Central and Eastern Europe, had to take emergency measures. Sometimes rather drastic emergency measures were taken. Well, drastic cuts in wages, especially public sector wages. Cuts sometimes in social benefits, pensions, and so forth. These exercises show some interesting new features. I could say positive features. We had autonomous independent initiatives by trade union confederations and employers.
Saying that social dialogue is part of the answer, clearly is part of the strategies to face the crisis. But not without many questions, not without many difficulties, because I think social dialogue is not an easy process, because we are talking about sacrifices, we are talking about compromises, and this will not go without difficulties and sometimes even break off in the negotiations.